Welcome back to the Beach Mom Bookworm. I am Tiffany. I'm so glad y'all found me again today. My channel is all about cozy mysteries and romance books. And today I am doing, I can't believe I'm saying this, October 2022 new cozy mystery releases part one. These are the traditionally published cozies. It feels like I just did September. Of course, it was only a few weeks ago. But you know what I mean? It's just like time. Whew. This is one of my favorite videos. I love to see what we're getting that's new. So exciting. Let me know which of these that you're excited about. Let me know if you one of these series is your favorite. Anything else that you want to talk about down in the comments is the place to do it. On your way down to comment, don't forget to stop and hit the subscription and the notification bell. Notification bell is going to tell you when I put out new videos each and every single week so you don't miss anything. I've been putting them up about twice a week on Sunday or Monday and then either Thursday or Friday. So look for those, but if you have the notification bell, it'll always notify you. The subscription keeps my channel growing, and I'm so thankful for that. It's been nothing but amazing. I'm having so much fun, and you guys are all to thank for that. So let's get into it. We're looking at October 2022 Cozy Mystery Releases, part one, in 3, 2, 1, go! All right, before we get into this list, let's do announcements. On Monday, reading sprints, I believe they're on Lee's channel this week from Dark Roots Creation. She switches off weeks with Storm Reads. Those are at 7 p.m. Eastern time. On Wednesday, I'm not going to be doing reading sprints this week. It is my week. However, one of the other gals, maybe Sarah from the Bookish Knitter, is going to take it over. But you'll hear about those updates later on in the week. And then on Saturdays, this coming Saturday, we have the Killing Time Cozies. It's a general Saturday. Don't forget to check out the Halloween challenge. It starts October 1st. It's coming up. It's going to be fabulous. It's going to be so much fun. All right, let's get started. The first one that we have for new books is book number 16 in the Trash and Treasure series. It's called Antiques Liquidation. It's going to be right here. This is by Barbara Allen. It says the main character, Brandy Bourne, and Sushi, her Shih Tzu, which is really funny. And actually, I don't know why I remember this, but the dog that won the big, huge dog show of the year last year was named Sushi. I don't know. I don't remember even, it's not something normally we tune in for. I don't remember why it was on, but I just remember thinking, that's such a cute name. Next up, we have a series. I read book one in. I really need to get back to this series because I actually really enjoyed it. Book one, it's the Mad for Mod series. Number 10 is coming out. It's called Love Me or Grieve Me right here. This is by Diane Valor. The main character is Madison Knight. She's an interior decorator and she's in love with Doris Day. So she's very into that time period as well in her decorating. And I just really enjoyed the first book. I would love to get back to that. Next up, this series is so long running. I think I've read through maybe the first 15 or so. I need to get back to it. What I binged it when I first started reading cozies and I read every one that was out. And then I started reading other things. And then I look back and I'm like, holy crap, there's another 15 books that have been added. Because right now book number 32 is coming out. It's part of the Meg Langslow series. This is by Donna Andrews. It's going to be called Dashing Through the Snowbirds. So our main character, Meg Langslow, she's a blacksmith. This takes place in Virginia. I absolutely love this series. I think this series for me has one of the most character growth of any cozies that I've read. Next up, we have a series I haven't checked out, but every time I see one of these covers, I think, oh, I need to get to this. It's book number 26. It's a Christmas book. It's going to be called Santa's Little Yelpers. Look at the cover. It's so cute. This is part of the Andy Carpenter series. This is by David Rosenfeld. It says our main character is Andy Carpenter, who is a defense attorney and manages a dog rescue place in New Jersey. I've heard a lot of great things about this. I would love to get to this series soon. Next up, we have a classic. It's a new Agatha Raisin. Book 33 is coming out. It's going to be called Devil's Delight. This is by MC Beaton. Our main character is Agatha Raisin, who's an advertising exec who's retired in England. I actually love the cover on this side. The colors are amazing. I have mixed feelings about I haven't read any of these, but I have mixed feelings about starting this series. But I just need to give it a shot and see what I think of it. Next up is one I'm super excited about because I loved book one. It's the second book in the Caribbean Kitchen mystery series. This is by Raquel V. Reyes. The book is going to be called Calypso, Corpses, and Cooking. I love it. I love the cover. I'm so excited for this. The book one was so good. And I met Raquel at Malice and she was amazing. This is set in Miami. It features Cuban American cooking show star Miriam Quinoez Smith. I'm probably not saying that wrong. Somebody let me know politely how to say it so I can change that. She is a food anthropologist. I thought that was the coolest thing. I've never heard of that, and I certainly never heard of it in a cozy. I just think that is incredible. She moves from New York to Coral Shores, Miami. She puts her academic career on hold to be a stay-at-home mom for her young son. And her best friend encourages her to join this cooking show on this local public station. And I really, really enjoyed it. I can't wait to get back to the second book. Next up, we have book two in a series. It's called High Spirits. This is by Carol J. Perry. It's part of the Haunted Haven mystery series. It says our main character is Maureen, and she is the owner of an old inn in Haven, Florida. I'm going to have to try this. I read a couple books in one of her other series. I think it was called The Witch City. I loved the first one. The second one was just too paranormal for me. If you're a paranormal fan, you'll absolutely love it. And the premise is amazing in that other one. But I'm really excited about this one. It takes place in Florida, which is where I live. And I love inns. An old inn sounds fabulous. So I'm going to check that one out. Next up is book 10 in the Bookmobile Cat Mystery series. It's called The Crime That Binds. This is by Lori Cass. Our main character is Minnie. She is a bookmobile librarian, and it also features Eddie, her rescue cat. This takes place in Michigan. I've had this on my TBR for a while. I love any book about books. Perfect. Next up is a new series. New series alert, and takes place in Ireland. So this is by Carlene O'Connor, who also writes another series that takes place in Ireland. But this one's going to be the County Kerry cozy mystery series. First book is called No Strangers Here. It says our main character is a veterinarian in County Kerry. I think that this sounds amazing. I'm actually really excited to check this out. Next up, we have book 7 coming out. It's called Christmas Angels. This is part of the Mary Alcutt Cozy Mystery series. It's by Alice Duncan. It says our main character is Mercy Alcutt, who's the owner of a rooming house in 1920s Hollywood. I keep saying it, but this is another one that was straight on my TBR. 1920s is one of my favorite periods, and old Hollywood, I'm going to have to at least try it. I'm so excited. If anybody's read that, let me know what you think. Next up, I know a lot of people who are going to be excited about a new book in this series. It's the Library Lovers series, book 13, The Plot and the Pendulum. This is, of course, by Jim McKinley. Our main character is Lindsay Norris, who's the library director of a library in Connecticut. I'm almost caught up in this series, and I am absolutely loving it. Next up is book 25 in the Sarah Booth Delaney series. It's called Bones of Holly right here. This is by Carolyn Haynes. This is one I'm excited for because I read the first one and I think I built it up too much in my head when I knew it was coming out, the first one, because I don't feel like we have a lot of cozies that take place in mountain lodges. And I think I just had too many expectations of what I wanted. And so I ended up giving book one 3 stars, which is a great rating. 3 cups of coffee is a great rating. However, in my head, I was really expecting like 5 stars. I'm going to be, you know, thrilled. But I think it was more me. So I'm excited that book two is coming out and I can get back to it and give it a fair shake. It's the Mountain Lodge Cozy Mystery Series. Book two is called A Trip with Trouble. This is by Diane Kelly. Our main character is Misty Murphy, and she's a recent divorcee in her 50s who opens a mountain lodge in the Blue Ridge Mountains. Can't wait to give this another shot. And 3 cups of coffee is still a great read, so I'll probably continue it either way, but I really do think that I didn't give it a fair deal going into the first one. This next one, is a brand new series, and I am super excited about it. I absolutely love the cover on this, and I know it was on NetGalley for a while, but I missed being able to request it, and I'm so sad because I just think it looks adorable. I love holiday cozies. We're talking about book one in the Killer Chocolate Cozy Mystery series. It's going to be called A Christmas Candy Killer. Isn't the cover amazing? Yeah, I absolutely love it. So this is by Christina Romero. It says, identical twin sisters, Alex and Hannah, are the owners of Murder and Mayhem. I love it. A mystery bookshop that sells famous poison-themed killer chocolates. I cannot wait. That sounds fabulous and a great business idea. Poisonous themed killer chocolates. I don't know who your target audience would be, but I think that's a fun idea. Oh, another one I'm super excited about. I know you probably are like, oh, you keep saying that, but there's just so many good books releasing. It's another new series alert. This author is one I really enjoy her writing. And it takes in place in Vermont. And it's about maple syrup. That's right. I'm talking about the new Maple Syrup Cozy Mystery series. Book one is A Doomful of Sugar. Love that title. This is by Catherine Brunt. I love her Cookies and Chance series. And I really got, I want to continue in the Italian Kitchen series as well by her. This one says, there's nothing sweet about murder. Layla has always believed that everyone loved her father as much as they loved his maple syrup. But when he's killed and she returns to Sugar Ridge, cute, Vermont, I'm so excited, to take over his business, she starts to realize how much of his life she's left untapped. With her brother under suspicion, her mother just barely holding it together, and police not producing any leads, Layla will have to investigate herself if she wants answers to her father's sticky end. I'm so excited for numerous reasons. Like I said, maple syrup, I think is a fun idea. I've read another series that was about maple syrup and I really enjoyed it from Jesse Crockett. I love Vermont. I'm just really thrilled with this one. Next up is one that, this is a series I'm really thankful for because I feel like it opened the door to a lot of people who didn't know about cozies. Because it was picked as the very first cozy mystery for Book of the Month Club. It's the Tita Rosie's Kitchen. A new book is coming out, book three. It's called Black Bale and Babinka, right here. This is by Mia P. Monanzala, who I met at Malice. She was amazing. She won the breakout author at Malice. It was really exciting. So this one is a series that started in 2021, set in Illinois, which is where I'm originally from. It says, Leela moves back to home to recover from a horrible breakup. Her life seems to be following all the typical rom-com tropes. She's tasked with saving her Tita Rosie's failing restaurant, and she has to deal with a group of matchmaking aunties who shower her with love and judgment. I want to get back to this. I read the first one. I really enjoyed it. The second one I've heard a lot of things about, and I just need to give it a shot for myself and go from there. Next up is the Jane Doe Book Club Mystery Series. Book number three is coming out, called Crime for the Books, right here. This is by Kate Young. This series is set in Georgia. It features Lila Moody, who loves her sleepy little town of Sweet Mountain, Georgia. She likes her job as a receptionist to her uncle's private investigation firm and her fellow true crime obsessed Jane Doe book club members. Together, they solve murders. Jane, true crime book club. Interesting. Next up is a series that's been on my TBR for a long time. Book number 10 is coming out, Death by Spiced Chai. This is the 10th book in the Bookstore Cafe Cozy Mystery series by Alex Erickson. This is a series that's set in Ohio. It features bookstore cafe owners Chrissy and her best friend Vicky. Together, they solve murders. Again, anything to do with bookstores, and I'm in. Next up is book two in the Paint by Murder Cozy Mystery series. It's called Kill Them with Canvas. This is by Bailey Abbott. This says that it's a series that takes place in New York. A quiet lakeside town in western New York State is the new home of Manhattan artist Chloe Abington and the backdrop for murder in this series debut. For Chloe Abington, the transition from fine art painter in New York City to painting event business owner in Charming Whisper Cove is more than a little jarring. Interesting. I love event planning cozies. I've read a few and I just really enjoy them, usually because it involves a really cool event that brings the town together and you get to see like more personality of the town and all that. And I just really, really enjoy it. So I might have to check this one out. I really like the title of this next one. It's called Live and Let Grind. This is the third book in the Coffee Lovers Cozy Mystery series by Tara Lush. This series is set in Florida. It features Lana Lewis, who's the owner of Purgatory Coffee Shop. That is an amazing name. That's hilarious. This next one I'm super excited about because I read the first one and it was a 5-cup of coffee read, probably even more than that. It was one of my favorites of the year. It's part of the Books and Biscuits Cozy Mystery series. Book 2 is called Soul of a Killer, right here. This is by Abby Collette, who also writes an amazing ice cream shop. I just really enjoy her writing. So in this one, there's a brother and sister twins. This series is set in Washington. It says when Kobe Hill and Keaton Rutledge were orphaned at age 2, they were separated, but their unbreakable connection lingered. Years later, they reunite and decide to make up for lost time and capitalize on their shared interests by opening up a well-stocked bookstore and a cozy soul food cafe in the Pacific Northwest town of Timber Lake. Oh, I couldn't be more excited. Kobe, which is the male because it's a brother and sister twins, was one of my favorite characters of the year. He is so empathetic. I just really, really related to him and how he was just had so much empathy for other people and the struggles that people go through. Really, really enjoyed his character and I can't wait to read this new one. Next up is book 8 in the Haunted Bookshop series. It's going to be called The Ghost and the Stolen Tears. This is by Cleo Coyle, who writes the coffee shop series that I love. I've never read any from this, but it's been on my TBR. This series takes place in Rhode Island, which I probably need a Rhode Island cozy. Interesting. It says it features Penelope Thornton McClure and the ghost of Jack Shepard. Penelope moves to Rhode Island with her son from New York after her husband commits suicide. Jack Shepard helps Penelope solve murder. She co-owns a bookshop with her aunt Sadie. Let me know who's read that and what you think of it. Another new series alert. It's going to be called Cancer with a Killer. It's going to be a horse rescue cozy mystery series by Amber Camp. I think that sounds great. I don't know much more about it, but I will definitely be checking it out. So the last book I have today is called The Plot Thickets, which is a great title. It's part of the Garden Squad Cozy Mystery series by Julia Henry. It says it takes place in Massachusetts. It features Lily Jane as our main character, who is part of a garden squad in a picturesque town of Goose Bush. That sounds like a lot of fun. Let me know which cozies you're most excited about. Give me a big thumbs up for this video. And until next time, may all your future reads be 5 stars. Bye!